The umbrellas were out on a windy and rainy night in Red Bank. The Shore's top two non-public teams collide. Donovan Catholic facing unbeaten Red Bank Catholic. The weather was the dominant storyline in this showdown. RBC forced a punt on its opening drive. With the rain and wind whipping, the snap gets away. The Caseys can't get off the punt. Donovan Catholic gets the ball at the 2-yard line. On the very next play, Jalen Butler, no problem. 2-yard touchdown run. What a way to start for the Griffins. It's quickly 6-0. And Donovan goes for two after a penalty on the extra point. Butler running the option. He gets to the corner and put two on the board. It's 8-0 Griffins. Later in the first, Donovan with the ball near midfield. Alex Bauman gets in the backfield for the tackle for loss. Both defenses would dominate the highlights in this one. Late in the first now, RBC punting it away. The rain coming down steady, and there's a fumble. Christian Ungema recovers it. Now you can't advance a muff punt, so no touchdown, but the Caseys do get the ball in Donovan Catholic territory. 8-0 Griffins heading into the second. RBC would get it into the red zone. Alex Brown under pressure. Levi Watkins comes in for the QB sack. Same drive, 4th and 2 from the 10. Rajon Cooper looking for the first down, but that's Hunter Johnson making a tackle. What a big stop by the Donovan defense as it stays an 8-0 game. Later in the second, another snap affected by the wet weather. J.J. Correa making the tackle on the punt attempt. The Griffins get the ball in RBC territory with 3:19 to go in the half. And Donovan marches right down the field. Jet sweep to Kyrie Drake. He gets to the edge and leaps his way into the zone. 13 yards to the dangerous wideout. The extra point is no good. At the half, Donovan Catholic has a 14-0 lead. Third quarter, nearly every play in the first half was a run, but look at Jalen Butler throwing in the rain. Huge third down conversion as Dante Vernieri makes the catch. First down, Griffins at the 29. Same drive, 4th and 1. There's a problem on the exchange. We've got a fumble. Jaden Haynes on the bottom of the pile comes up with it. RBC takes over. Plenty of time left. It's still a 14-0 game. RBC was looking for a spark. Deep in their own territory, the Caseys try a fake punt. Donovan Catholic's all over it. Nico Ippolito and Nat Ionello on the stop as the Griffins take over at the 26. The Caseys defense kept them in the football game. Here's Rajon Cooper causing a fumble. How about Jaden Haynes with his second turnover of the quarter? The Caseys need that one big play to get them right back into the game. There's so much talk about Donovan's high-powered offense, but this Griffins defensive unit was stellar in a high-stakes game. Vernieri making plays on both sides of the ball. We head to the fourth. It's still 14-0 Griffins. The DC offensive line was outstanding. They won the battle in the trenches. Nunes Bukula finding the lane. That's a 7-yard touchdown run to make it a 21-0 game. RBC was able to get on the board midway through the fourth. Alex Brown throwing downfield. Robert Stolfa with a 48-yard touchdown. That makes it 21-7. But Donovan Catholic would put the game away. Nunu Bukula had a monster game. He is one of New Jersey's underrated running backs. Bukula bruising his way to a 52-yard touchdown run. He tops 100 yards on the ground, and the Griffins make their claim to be the top team in the Shore Conference. 28-7 is your final. RBC's got to shake off this loss and focus on the non-public B-State playoffs, where the Caseys still expect to be one of the top seeds. Meanwhile, Donovan Catholic had to forfeit 3 games due to a clerical error with a sophomore player. The Griffins are technically 5-4, but they're really an 8-1 team. They enter the non-public A tournament on a roll. Whether it's tough weather conditions or the forfeits, the adversity has served DC well.
I think that turned around our season completely. It definitely gave us a chip on our shoulder.
Yeah, absolutely.
In what way?
I mean, it just gave us fuel every week. That was something to be mad about. It was something to give us energy when we felt dead, you know?
It was rainy, so it was a, tough game. But I just want to say thank you to my coaches. Obviously, starts with the O-line, Taz, Nico, Coombs, EJ, Rob on them, you know. It starts with them first. So started off bad, caught a couple fumbles, came out second half, did our thing.
In Red Bank, I'm Rich Krampanis for JerseySportsZone.com.